And still ahead, Singapore is aiming to halve its carbon emissions in less than 30 years. Our CNA Plus discussion will rake through how it's planning to achieve this ambitious target.
On CNA.
Renewable energy, food wastage and plastic pollution. That's just some of the environmental issues that MoneyMind will be focusing on in its Green Business Series. As Singapore continues its push to lower carbon emissions and tackle climate change issues, we shine a spotlight, or the spotlight, I should say, on some of the local businesses that are doing their part, Julie.
Right. A series producer, Jonathan Peeris, and founder of Eigen Energy, Kevin Sim, are with us this morning. Welcome to both. John, let's start with you. I mean, talk to us about why you chose to highlight local startups in the green space and what some of the different areas the Eco Entrepreneur series will focus on.
Yes, well, you know, part of this whole push towards climate change is to help our local industries to get into the space and do their bit. And we decided to focus on renewable energy, food waste, and plastic pollution in particular. It's three topics that I think, you know, it's very close to Singaporeans' heart, especially in the last couple of years. So in the next few episodes, we'll be focusing on a few companies that are dealing with the food waste problem, which is huge here in Singapore, where we love our food. It's a company called Ento Industries, which grows black soldier flies, which can treat most types of food waste and turn it into agricultural feedstock. And another company called Crust, which upcycles fruit peels and bread and turns them into craft beers and non-alcoholic products. But for this first episode, we're going with renewable energy. And for that, we're looking at solar in particular, which, you know, as you know, is the most viable renewable energy that we have in Singapore due to our size and lack of natural resources. And for that, we're featuring Eigen Energy, which is a local startup that is involved in setting up, installing solar panels and maintaining them. And for that, we have the founder, Kevin Sim, as well here today.
Yeah, good morning, Kevin. It's great for you to join us on such a great initiative here. Listen, you know, Eigen Energy, of course, is one of the local firms that's being featured in the series. And we understand you specialize in solar energy systems. Great to see that Singapore's rolling this out to try and sort of reduce their carbon footprint. I mean, what made you decide to get into the solar industry?
Right. So I've always been very fascinated by solar energy. And, you know, back in school, we used to have this like solar car race. And then, you know, it always fascinated me how a vehicle was able to power without fuel and just purely by sunlight. So back when we first started, the technology was just on the cusp of economic viability. And fundamentally, the way that we generate and consume energy was overdue for a transition to one of a low carbon. So we wanted to offer solutions and assist entities, you know, with their transition and over to clean energy.
And Kevin, we understand the solar energy industry, like any industry, is part of a very dynamic market. What are some of the trends you're seeing in the solar energy space here in Singapore?
Sure. So fundamentally, the solar generation itself is just part of a larger ecosystem. And beyond that, we see other pieces of this infrastructure coming to place. So on top of solar, you have, you know, batteries to mitigate against intermittency in the generation. You also have smarter grid management to deal with all this decentralized power generation assets.
Right, let's get back to you, John. I mean, since we're talking about solar energy, what are the potential opportunities for these solar energy companies, whether they're a startup or established, whether it's here or potentially regionally, you know, around ASEAN, that are looking to capture some of these opportunities?
Well, you know, Adam, solar has come a long way in Singapore in the last 10 years. In fact, our installed solar capacity has increased more than 100-fold, from 3.8 megawatt peak in 2010 to around 400 megawatt peak last year in mid-2020. And the government has announced plans to accelerate efforts. They basically want to quadruple our solar capacity to 1.5 gigawatt peak by 2025. Now, it's a huge opportunity for companies like Eigen, who are involved in installation and maintenance of PVs. And it's not just for commercial buildings or factories either. They're looking at more floating solar farms, similar to the one that we have at Tengeh Reservoir, which is one of the largest in the world. And they're also studying the feasibility of solar panels, not just in the roofs of buildings, but also on the facades and even noise barriers along MRT tracks and expressways. The reality is Singapore's energy needs are only going to increase, especially since we're doing this whole push, you know, towards electric vehicles. Singapore wants to phase out combustion engine vehicles by 2040. I mean, that's going to mean tons of charging points. It's going to have to require more electricity in the grid, and solar is going to play a huge part of that.
Yeah, you mentioned a very interesting point of, you know, solar panels. We always think that those are on the roof, but, you know, Kevin, research shows only 5% of homeowners in Singapore live in landed properties, which means unless you own a building or live in a landed property, most of us won't be able to install solar panels on our roofs. So what are other ways to utilize the solar energy?
So right now there is something called a off-site power purchase agreement. So a lot of solar developers right now, they are actually installing on commercial buildings or large roof spaces, and in turn selling this clean green energy over to consumers like you and I. So there are avenues and ways to actually consume cleaner energy or to make a decision to select cleaner energy as we go along.
Kevin, thank you very much for joining us. Wish you the best of luck with Eigen Energy as you tap into those growth opportunities.
Thank
and Jonathan, thank you so much for your time this morning as well. And you can catch the first episode of Money Minds Eco Entrepreneurs this Saturday at 10:30 p.m. on CNA.